you, flyboy.
This is a rebellion, isn't it?
I call it aggressive negotiations.
The garbage will do!
Welcome to this week's Trash Compactor podcast, Star Wars from a Certain Point of View. I'm Emcee and I'm here with...
I'm Sarah.
So it's been a week of good news, bad news in terms of Star Wars stuff. And first of all, the bad news, which is also kind of good news. They've finally postponed Star Wars Celebration from August of this year to August 2022. Which, it sucks that we're not going to have Celebration this year, but considering everything that's going on, probably for the best.
I'm just glad that they made the decision, and that we don't have to make the decision whether to go or not.
Yeah, because I think you and I had already decided that we could not go. I mean, technically, right now, I can't, because the border between the U.S. and Canada is not open yet. And it's actually... 6-1, half a dozen on the other, as to whether or not it'll be open by then.
Mm-hmm. So Celebration is postponed till 2022, at which point we'll have lots and lots of news there.
Yes, we will have lots of news. We do have some fantastic news that just kind of
happened. It came out of nowhere.
It really did. Like, it was one of those things that, like, we had hoped that it was going to be a thing, and we thought that it might be Project Luminous, and we've talked about it possibly as being Project Luminous, but then when Project Luminous was announced to be High Republic, we kind of just forgot all about it, because it just kind of became like that thing in the back of our heads that probably isn't going to happen. But then all of a sudden it came down that From a Certain Point of View strikes back for the 40th anniversary of The Empire Strikes Back. They are doing From a Certain Point of View, too. It's 44 Yay! Stories set during The Empire Strikes Back. And yeah, we were totally surprised by this, probably because we thought that it would have been announced well before this.
Right, because the 40th anniversary has come and gone now.
Yeah.
So we figured it would be announced and it would probably be released around May.
From a Certain Point of View was released for the 40th of Star Wars, wasn't it?
It was released in October, though.
Okay.
I think it was announced on May the 4th that year, I think.
Yeah, but I mean, like, this, From a Certain Point of View, the announcement wasn't for May the 4th. The announcement wasn't even for the 40th anniversary. It came several weeks afterwards. So, it just all of a sudden was there. And I'm going to... Again, might be something that we can chalk up to the whole COVID thing, where it's been very hard to work things out in this world. So maybe they had to put it off a little bit. Or maybe they just didn't care. Because the thing is, I don't care. I really don't care.
I was going to say, or maybe they just wanted to hold something back to give us that light in the middle of quarantine.
That is very true, because I mean, they did, for May the 4th, they did have Clone Wars, and they didn't do anything for the 40th, but you know, that's fine. And they just wanted to surprise us, and I'm honestly, from a certain point of view, doesn't need to depend on anniversaries, especially like so the way I see it, they could have gotten away with writing just the first one. Like,
right.
They could have written the first one and that would be it, because it's like, it's the first Star Wars movie, that's done. Mm-hmm. But now that they're doing Empire, they have to do Jedi.
And once they've done Jedi, they can do the prequels?
Well, yeah. I mean, like, I think they can, the way it goes, it's like, you can either do one, you can do three.
Or you do three sets of three.
You can do three sets of three. Yeah. So, I mean, like, there's different stages of it. And I think, considering how the response is, it wouldn't surprise me if they want to do all of them. Mm-hmm. And they're not going to wait for the 40th anniversary of any of the other movies, because they can't. There's too long. They could maybe do the, you know, 25th anniversary for Phantom Menace.
That's what I was trying to count.
Yeah, because we just had the 20th, didn't we?
Yeah, last year. I was trying to think how much space there would be between the 40th of Jedi and the 25th of Phantom Menace.
I think it's like 2 years.
Right. So that would work perfect. But back to Empire.
So this book is coming out. Did they actually announce a date for it, or did they just say
November 10th.
November 10th. So that is a book I will get day it comes. I get most of the Star Wars books day they come out. This will definitely be one that I get. I might even just get the digital so that I can be sure to have it.
Yeah.
Because
I did not get the first one the day it came out because I had the special New York Comic Con release edition pre-ordered for that one. And that was 4 days later.
I needed to wait on that. 4 days later, you were getting ready for a convention, so.
Oh, well, but I had an hour and a half train ride. I could have gotten it and brought it with me, but I wanted to wait and read the fancy, pretty convention edition version.
Fair.
It's a great list of authors so far. Did they announce everyone yet? I don't really feel like counting this. It doesn't look like 40 there, but...
It doesn't.
It might be. But it's a lot of names we know, but also a lot of names we don't.
Yeah. No, I mean, there's definitely, we've got a lot of the standard, authors, the kind of the stable of authors for Star Wars these days. But then there are people that, we haven't seen before, or maybe we did see from a certain point of view one, and I just can't remember.
I think they were trying to get some new people also, though.
And it looks like a couple of them, we have some, teasers about what's going to be going
on. Yeah, none of the teasers grab my attention real hard. I mean, I know I'm going to read them and love them. But, there's things I'm hoping for.
Yeah, so. Well, I mean, this is the thing that I really wanted to talk about when talking about, from a certain point of view, Empire. I think Empire is possibly the hardest one to write.
I can see that.
Because we have, if you look at from a certain point of view, one, there's a lot of stuff in the cantina.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, they've kind of married themselves to this 40 stories thing now. So it's easy to get 40 for A New Hope. It's super easy to get 40 for Return of the Jedi. And I would say for the prequels and sequels, also easy to get 40. But Empire is such I don't want to say a small story, but I guess a personal story.
An intimate story.
An intimate story. That's a very good way to put it. So much of it is set just on the Falcon. So much of it is set on Dagobah. You do have the set piece, the Battle of Hoth. So I'm sure you're going to love it because there's going to be lots of stories about pilots.
Yep.
And obviously they're going to have a story for every single one of the bounty hunters.
Probably. I mean, they've announced Dengar and IG-88.
Yeah.
One story, not two. Yeah, they probably will have a story for each one, and that's okay.
Yeah. Yeah, and I think also, so the conceit is that it's stories from characters who aren't major characters. Mm-hmm. But what do we define as a major character? Because from a certain point of view, one, we had a story from Yoda, we had a story from Obi-Wan. Basically, is it everybody but the main three?
Basically, I think.
Okay. But I would think with Empire, they probably wouldn't do one for Lando.
Probably not. He's too big of a part in that story.
Yeah. But Lobot?
That's the one I was just thinking, was Lobot.
Also, do you know what? I'm going to be super disappointed if they do not do a story from Ice Cream Man's perspective.
Oh, that would be wonderful. That would be such an Easter egg for people that know what it is. And otherwise, it would be just a story.
Yeah, considering how he's become so beloved in Star Wars fandom, and they have to be aware of it, because, I mean, at Star Wars Celebration, they do, the running of the, of the ice cream makers. they brought it back in Mandalorian, so.
Yep.
We could finally find out what's in that Camtono.
That's true.
Or maybe it'll be like Pulp Fiction, where we just never find out what's in it.
And you know what? I'd be good with either.
I know, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, there is possibilities. There's
a lot of background characters in Empire.
Yeah.
So, you know, there might be chunks that they can't do because all it is on the Falcon.
Yeah.
Or on Dagobah. But there's still enough background characters everywhere else. Mm-hmm. I mean, half the book could be on Hoth between the Empire and the Rebellion.
They could also get very creative because, I mean, isn't there a line in Empire about, like, 3PO fighting with the Falcon?
Possibly?
I believe that there is a line in there about 3PO's, like, I don't know where your ship learned to do blah, blah, mm-hmm. blah, blah, blah. So do one from L3.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because that's something that we didn't have when, from a certain point of view, 1 came mm-hmm. out. We did not know that, like, the Falcon has Lando's droid in it.
Right. I mean, and now I just thought of another one. Since the first one, we've had absolute confirmation that Ahsoka is still running around out there.
Yeah.
Just toss the idea out into the world before. Yeah, I mean, we didn't know that she lived.
Yeah.
Before.
There is a lot of fun stuff that they can do. And, you know, I have talked about the Tales of books before. And I mean, like, in the Tales of Jabba's Palace book, they had a story from Mara Jade. Who was not in Return of the Jedi.
Right.
You know, it's just like she was, you know, it's like she was always just, you know, off camera, just a little tiny bit.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, like, there's ways that they can stretch it. And I'm totally looking forward. Like, actually, by not having as many characters that, you know, like, get actual shots, like in the cantina scene, they can be even more creative, because mm-hmm. that was one of the problems that I had with From a Certain Point of View, is that we were in that cantina for a long time. Like, how many times did we see Greedo get shot?
I know. I love the stories taken individually, but yeah. Just one after another, after another, after another.
Yeah, so this way we can, you know, stretch our legs, really mm-hmm. get into things. So the stories we have in teasers for are, it's Austin Walker, who I'm not familiar with,
no.
is writing the unlikely partnership of bounty hunters Dengar and IG-88 as they pursue Han Solo. Hank Green, who I know but is new to writing Star Wars, I believe, chronicles the life of a naturalist caring for tauntauns on the frozen world of Hoth. Tracy Dion delves into the dark heart of the Dagobah cave where Luke confronts a terrifying vision. That I'm kind of interested in because, you know, I like weird Force stuff.
Yep, that one's going to be intriguing, I hope.
Martha Wells reveals the world of the Ugnaught clans who dwell in the depths of Cloud City. Mark Oshiro recounts the Wampa's tragic tale of loss and survival. That just gives me Darksaber flashbacks.
Yeah, okay.
And Seth Dickinson interrogates the cost of serving a ruthless empire aboard the bridge of a doomed Imperial starship. So, I mean, those are, you know...
They sound interesting.
Those sound interesting, and it does sound like they're really kind of, you know, going outside the box in terms of stories. And mm-hmm. I mean, I do think it's interesting that they're putting two of the bounty hunters together in a story, which kind of suggests to me that they're not doing one for each one.
But didn't Dengar and IG-88 run around together before also?
I can't remember.
I think they were always a partnership.
But some of the other authors that we're getting are Delilah S. Dawson, Alexander Freed, Jason Fry, Christy Golden.
She hasn't written for Star Wars in a while, has she?
Yeah. No. Let's see who else.
E.K. Johnston.
E.K. Johnston, Daniel Jose Older, Kevin Scott.
Oh, John Jackson Miller hasn't done stuff in a bit. Has he done any new? No, he has done something new canon, hasn't he? It's been a while, though.
Sure, he did something from a certain point of view. It has been a while.
I'm thinking other than the first From a Certain Point of View. But yeah, it's a nice group of writers we got listed here.
Yeah. Yeah, and I think they'll probably still be announcing more, because I don't think it's 40 yet. And now you've got me looking up John Jackson Miller to see if, based off of Wikipedia, hasn't done anything since A New Dawn. He did a story in Canto Bight.
Okay, and there are 33 writers announced so far.
Okay, groovy.
At least out of quick count.
John Jackson Miller's actually mostly been doing Star Trek stuff these days.
Oh, funny.
He is not the only one.
No.
Okay, so we've already talked about some of our ideas for what could happen. What's the one story that you want?
You know what I'm going to say, and I'm not going to say it.
I know what you're going to say.
No, and I'm not going to say it.
You're not going to say it.
Because I want a tragic story from Dak's perspective.
Do you know what? I was going to say Dak.
Fine, you can have Dak. I want Wedge. I'll say it. I will always want Wedge.
I want both of them. Like I want Wedge and Dak. And now that you mention Ahsoka, like I would really like an Ahsoka story. Or do you know what? If not just an Ahsoka, I want a Rebels story.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, we don't have all of them, but this book has come out like Rebels had not finished when that had come out. So like we know that Hera, Rex, all of these people were around up until Return of the Jedi. So can we please have a story where we get some information on them? Like, where is Hera during Empire Strikes Back?
Right. I mean, they're not going to do Rex. Because if they do, they're going to hold that one for Jedi.
Yeah.
And oh, just God. Confirm that. Officially, see, finally.
Just by saying that, I'm like, now they have to come out with Jedi, because if they don't, I'm going to be super mad that I don't get my Rex story.
Yeah. But yeah, any of the Ghost Crew would be awesome. Yeah.
And hey, there's authors that haven't been announced yet, mm-hmm. so like maybe we can, I don't know, does Filoni do any short story writing?
I don't think so, but that doesn't mean he... I don't think he has, but that doesn't mean he doesn't. But yes, there is a lot more options and things out there. I mean, you drag Aphra back into it.
Yeah.
I mean, I think there was an Aphra story in the first one, though.
There was, but I mean, like, I'm always willing to check in on Aphra.
Mm-hmm. But just, it's nice that now there's so much more, and I can't think of the word, just brain fart, more...
There's a bigger universe.
Yeah, there's more than just the movie characters now to pull from.
Yeah.
So.
Just for our friend Tim, I'm going to say, let's do a story about Pride and show that he was around back during the Empire.
That would be great.
Our friend Tim really loves Pride.
Yeah.
I don't understand it, but I respect it.
Yeah, exactly. I don't get it, but more power to him.
We'll drag him on the podcast at some point. Mm-hmm. Interrogate him.
I wouldn't mind. Oh, I got another one. I wouldn't mind a Force Ghost Qui-Gon story.
I had thought of that too.
Just kind of going, well, I can't really talk to Obi-Wan right now. He's busy with Force Ghost leading Luke around, but watching over him because, you know, Obi-Wan still has Padawan.
Oh, there's just... Honestly, like I'm saying, it's like, it's so hard to come up with 40. And I'm like, we could come up with 100 of them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's going to come out. We're going to be, well, why did they do this one?
Yeah. But, you know, that's where fan fiction comes from.
Exactly.
So I think that brings us to the end of this little chat about From a Certain Point of View. Because we could keep on coming up with ideas until, like, the end of time. But... eventually the book's going to come out. So.
Yes. We just kind of wanted to do a, we're excited about this.
But yeah, no, we're excited about this. I mean, we've talked many, 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 many times about how much we want this.
Mm-hmm.
And honestly, by virtue of them doing a second one means that they're going to do a third one and possibly more after that. And I am here for all of them because I love these. These are my favorite of the Star Wars books.
Yeah, no, agree. And as a whole, yes, they are my favorite of the Star Wars books. I've got particular ones that are more favorite, but this is the one that I go back to.
Yeah. I think, I mean, that's the thing with an anthology, that you can, there are some stories that you really like, mm-hmm. and you don't have to read the entire thing cover to cover, because that's not how an anthology works.
Right, you just pick and choose your ones you feel like that day. And some days that might just be all of them.
That is, yeah. Which is actually works very well with the Star Wars movies themselves.
Yes.
It's like, sometimes I just want to watch one, and sometimes I want to watch all of them.
Exactly.
Okay, so tell us what you're looking forward to in From a Certain Point of View Strikes Back. What characters do you want to have stories? What characters do you not want to have stories? I can't really think of anybody that like I wouldn't be excited about. You can contact us on our Twitter at SW Trash Podcast, and you can contact me personally at Emcee Frodus.
I am on Twitter at Murnell.
And you can find us on YouTube, Facebook, Tumblr, at Trash Compactor Podcast. And if you enjoy our podcast and you want us to do more, please support us on Patreon. You can find us at Trash Compactor Podcast. And by supporting us, we will start doing more and more episodes about various fun things. So until next time, may the Force be with you.
Always. Oh, wait, I thought of one more story I want.
Okay.
So, Garrick is running around somewhere on Hoth. May the Force be with you.